Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Market Fatafat right here on ET Now. It's a quiet market, up 0.2%. The broader end of the market, though, is continuing its losing ways. 95 points down on the small cap index. But we have quite a few stocks that we'll be discussing today, so let's get straight to it. Our team of research analysts are all standing by, and Kunal Bothra and Sameer Chavan with us on the technicals. Well, right on then, let's also understand what the technical take is on Aurobindo. The stock is managing to buck the trend. Would you bet on it, Sameer?
Even this stock has been consolidating since last 1.5 months in a range of 784 to 735. So whenever it dips down towards 735, it tends to attract some kind of buying interest. At the same time, 784 seems to be very strong resistance. So as a trader, you know, one has to wait for a breakout to happen, decisive breakout beyond 784. That would confirm a breakout. In that case, the stock can head towards 810, 820. So as of now, we would expect continuation of this consolidation. One has to wait for a breakout to happen beyond 784.
All right, wait for the countdown. And Sameer, let's talk about Reliance Industries. How are you looking at the stock based on the chart pattern, given the fact that after the results, we saw quite a smackdown?
So the stock has been enjoying, you know, its 18 months bull run without any major correction. And in last 1.5 months, we have already seen some kind of, you know, profit booking happening from high levels. So the stock has corrected a bit, then again recovered, and now we, you know, believe that the stock is now likely to see some kind of time-wise consolidation, wherein the range on the higher side would be around 1140 and low side 1060. So we expect this consolidation to happen within this range of 50 to 60.
Let's move right on, shift gears then from banks to autos, and it's Bajaj Auto that is managing to hold out in top gear today. Sameer, what exactly is the trend that you're observing?
See, Evan, this has been a laggard for a while now. It is now trading around its multi-month support levels, which is in the zone of 2500-2450. Yes, today we are seeing some kind of, you know, positive traction in this counter. But, you know, 2650 is the level to watch out for. If the stock manages to sustain beyond 2650, then only we could see some short-term trend reversal happening in this counter. In that case, the stock can give a decent bounce back. But as of now, you know, one has to wait and watch. 2500 on the lower side and 2650 on the higher side. These are the levels to watch out for.
On that note then, we'll wrap it up right here on the show. From the entire team, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for Markets at Noon.